Welcome student,
let us start this new lesson, that is Chasing the Sea Monster. This lesson was written by this writer, that is Jules Verne. He was a French and he is known as a father of science fiction. So at the time when these scientific instruments are unknown, like submarines and frigates, that time he wrote the science fiction. Okay, he wrote about the rockets, space travel and submarines when such things were unknown. In this passage from his novel 20,000 Leagues Under the Sea, he describes how people on the ship thinks of the submarine as an animal and try to chase and hunt it. So this story is about the fictions of a warship, that is submarine. So let us continue and having an explanation about this lesson. So the lesson number 2.6, Chasing the Sea Monster. So our frigate wanted to go back. Frigate, a warship, okay, which is used in a war. But the unearthly animal came at us with a speed double our own. In this lesson, the writer wanted to say that when they wanted to go back, but unearthly means the unidentified animals or the animals which never seen before, okay, that come towards their frigate with the double speed. We gasped, more stunned than afraid. We stood mute and motionless. So they get alert. They were soldiers, so they get alert towards these animals. Okay, the animal caught up with us, played with us. It made a full circle around the frigate and wrapped us in a sheet of electricity that were like a luminous dust. At any instant, it could have a dash against our ship. So that animals have a very much speed than these frigates, and he take a round circle of this frigate and create a sheet of electricity through this his body. Okay, meanwhile I was surprised to see that our warship was fleeing, not fighting. So here the writer says that I was surprised that the frigate does not fight with that animal, but it was try to run away from that animals. I commented on this to Commander Farragut. His face, ordinarily so emotionless, showed a great astonishment. Okay, so with this surprise, the writer said to this commander of that frigate, but the face of that commander was very much emotionless. Okay, Professor Aronnax, he answered me, I don't know what kind of fearsome creature I am up against, and I don't want my frigate running foolish risk in all this darkness. Besides, how should we attack this unknown creature? How should we defend ourselves against it? Let us wait for a daylight and then we will play a different role. So the commander of that submarine or frigate answered that he don't know this type of creature. So he also don't know how to fight against that creature. How to fight against that creature. So he wanted to take care of the persons on the submarine or a frigate. he didn't want to take such decisions which will risk the life of the persons on that frigate. So he don't want to take a foolish risk in the night. So the period that creature is present in the war, that is in the dark night. So he didn't want to take any risk in such darkness. So he take a decision to wait a daylight, and after that they will take a decisions how to behave against this creature, unknown creature. The whole crew stayed on their feet all night long. No one even thought of sleeping. So the soldiers on that ship becomes alert, and they stood on their feet whole night. The crew means the member of the army members on the submarines or a ship. Okay, no one even thought of sleeping, means they remains alert whole night, unable to compete with the monster speed our frigate, the Abraham Lincoln, slow down. The speed of that unknown creature was very fast. So when they try to run away from that creature, the speed of that monster is double of that frigate. So the name of the frigate is Abraham Lincoln. That speed of the Abraham Lincoln, that is a frigate, slow down. For its part, the animal mimics copy. The frigate simply rode with the waves, but did not leave the field of battle. So that creature is adventurous animal, and he tried to copy of that frigate. So when frigate increase their speed, the unknown animal or creature also increase speed. Why? When the frigate slow down his speed, the creature also slow down its speed. So that unknown creature didn't left the battlefield, but he remains and keep a safe distance from this frigate. However, near midnight it disappeared. So at the time of midnight, that unknown creature suddenly disappeared, or to use a more appropriate expression, it went out like a huge glow worm. Had it fled from us, we didn't know, and were filled with a fear and hope at the same time. But at 12:53, the deafening hiss could be heard, resembling the sound made by the water spout expelled from the tremendous intensity. So here, after at the time of 12:53, this the sound of that unknown creature come to that frigate, and the intensity of that sound is very tremendous. By then, Commander Farragut, Ned Land, and I were also on the after deck, peering eagerly into the darkness. So here Commander Farragut upload that Ned Land means a missile of that frigate. Tell me, Ned Land, isn't that a noise cetaceans make when they spurt water from their blue shades? The very noise, sir,
but this one's way louder, so there can be no mistake. There's definitely a well lurking in our waters. Lurking means hiding. Okay. Lurking means hiding. The writer named that creature as a whale, and he said that the whale is try to hide. Near 2 o'clock in the morning, the core of a light reappeared 5 miles away from the Abraham Lincoln. So the lights are of situation under the sea, like a fog, it appears again in the distance of that core of light is merely about the 5 miles from that frigate. We stayed on the alert until daylight, getting ready for action. Whaling gears was set up along the railings. The chief officer loaded the blunderbusses, which can launch harpoons as far as a mile, and long duck guns means the sharpened point of the guns is very long. It is like a duck. Exploding bullets that can wound and kill even the most powerful animal. So the army on the frigates becomes alert for a war. They uploaded the guns which is ready to launch the harpoons. Harpoons, a submarine missile. Okay, it is very dangerous weapons that they wanted to use against this unknown creature. And the name of that missile is Ned Land. Was content of the sharpen his harpoon and dreadful animal, dreadful, very fierce weapon, okay, in his hand. At 6 o'clock, they began to break with a dawn's early light. The animal's electric glow disappeared. When there was a sunrise, that time the electric glows were disappeared. At 7 o'clock, a very dense morning mist spread around us. Mist of fog. Okay. Our best sunglasses, spyglasses, were unable. Spyglasses means through which they can see the different things, which is at the very long distance, that are called spyglasses. The spyglasses were unable to pierce it, so they were unable to see this monster with their spy glasses. At 8 o'clock, the mist rolled away and the horizon grew wider and clearer. Suddenly Ned Land's voice could be heard. There's the things, a questions astern a port. The harpner shouted, every eye looked towards the point indicated. So there's a mile and a half from the frigate, a long blackish body emerged a meter above the waves, quivering violently its tail. Was creating considerable current. The crews were waiting impatiently for orders from their leaders. So there was a time they take a decision to wait for the morning, and when the sun rises at the 8 o'clock, they threw their weapons, missiles, towards that animal.
where the directions are given. Okay. So students, we will stop here and get the more information about these lessons in the next lecture. I will send you a video of that lecture. Okay.